verses from Mark chapter 15. A certain man from Cyrene, Simon, the father of Alexander and Rufus, was passing by on his way in from the country, and they forced him to carry the cross. They brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. Then they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him. Dividing up his clothes, they cast lots to see what each would get. It was 9 in the morning when they crucified him. The written notice of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." They crucified 2 rebels with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by hurled insults at him, shaking their heads and saying, "So, you who are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, come down from the cross and save yourself." In the same way, the chief priests and the teachers of the law mocked him among themselves. "He saved others," they said, "but he can't save himself. Let this Messiah, this King of Israel, come down now from the cross, that we may see and believe." Those crucified with him also heaped insults on him. Amen. For those of you who've been following our Holy Week journey, we've been reading through the last few chapters of Mark's Gospel. And today we arrive here at the cross. It's Good Friday. So let's pause for a moment and pray. Lord Jesus, help us to look at the events of that first Good Friday afresh. Challenge us to open our eyes to see what really happened. Help us to appreciate what you did for us on that day and the effect it can still have on our world today. Amen. Our world has definitely been turned upside down lately, hasn't it? Everything that is normal has been turned on its head. Everyday activities like going to work or school, shopping at the supermarket, going to church, they've all changed or been taken away completely. It seems that everything has been turned upside down. As we reflect today on the events of Holy Week and Easter, we realise that God turns everything upside down. Easter is all about Jesus, and if we go back to the beginning of Jesus' life, he was born as a vulnerable baby. Weakness that gives us strength. God turns everything upside down. As Jesus grew, he befriended rejected people. Zacchaeus, Mary Magdalene. He befriended rejected people to show us acceptance. Rejection to acceptance. God turns everything upside down. Jesus performed all kinds of miracles, turning the impossible into possible. God turns everything upside down. And we arrive at Good Friday. Jesus took the punishment for each one of us to give us forgiveness. Punishment and forgiveness. God turns everything upside down. Jesus was disgraced so we could have grace. He died so that we could have life. God turns everything upside down. God turns our lives upside down. He changes weakness to strength, rejection to acceptance. The impossible is made possible. Instead of punishment, we have forgiveness. Instead of death, we have life. So as we look at the violent and sad events of Good Friday, we realise that this can be turned upside down too. We look forward to Easter Sunday and the empty cross and the empty tomb. And this emptiness is a sign that God will fill us with his love and grace. Emptiness is change to fullness. God turns everything upside down. So as we live through Good Friday and look towards Easter Sunday in a world that has turned upside down, let's thank Jesus for what he did for us. And remember that God turns everything upside down, including our lives. Listen to the next few verses in Mark chapter 15 as we reflect in this upside down world. At noon, darkness came over the entire land until 3 in the afternoon. And at 3, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of those standing near heard this, they said, "Listen, he's calling Elijah." Someone ran, filled a sponge with wine vinegar, and put it on a staff, and offered it to Jesus to drink. "Now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to take him down," he said. With a loud cry, Jesus breathed his last. The curtain of the temple was torn in two, from top to bottom. And when the centurion who stood there in front of Jesus saw how he died, he said, "Surely this man was the Son of God." Shall we pray? Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for what you did for us on the cross, for taking our punishment so we could have forgiveness, for dying so that we can have life, eternal life with God, God who turns everything upside down. Lord, we thank you that you still turn things upside down. And where there is fear today, help us to see your hope this Easter time. Amen.